On Tuesday, we'll see a chance of thunderstorms. Look for fair skies on Wednesday. And on Thursday, expect a chance of thunderstorms.
Here's a view of a tropical storm that few people get a chance to see. Astronauts on the Space Shuttle Discovery beamed down this orbiting view of Tropical Storm Chantal. The storm is making its way through the Caribbean toward the Mexican Yucatan Peninsula. Good morning this morning, and as we check out the latest weather scene, there will be a chance for some heavier showers and thunderstorms moving in across the country. We'll be saying more about that coming up in just a few moments. But first of all, let's start things off by looking at the very latest regarding Tropical Storm Chantal. Here's the latest information. Now, if you're tracking along with us, the latest coordinates are at 17.3 north, 84.8 degrees west, and we're still seeing that the winds are being clocked at 65 miles per hour as it continues to spin to the west-northwest. And we're not really foreseeing much change in strength or intensity or much change in the direction in the next 24 to about 36 hours or so. Now, at this point, we do have some advisories in effect. There are tropical storm warnings in effect for the Cayman Islands, also tropical storm warnings that extend from the coastal regions of Belize and extending northward up towards Cancun, Mexico. Along with that, too, hurricane watch is in effect from Cancun, Mexico, southward towards Belize City. Now, at the very least, we can expect some very squally conditions in and around these areas, as there will likely be tropical storm force winds, winds easily gusting over 40 miles per hour. So definitely some rough conditions expected over about the next 24 hours or so. Now, the latest satellite picture of Chantal showing that it's still very poorly organized, a very poorly organized center of circulation. In fact, we think the center could be somewhere right about here, with most of the convection staying to the north and east of the center of circulation. So with that in mind, again, it's showing us that this is a very poorly organized tropical system, but it's still more or less holding its own, still a tropical storm, and again, it's generally heading off to the west-northwest, heading closer towards the Yucatan Peninsula. And at this point, the latest speculation is that it could possibly be making landfall sometime later on tonight around the Yucatan, and then eventually over time, it could reemerge back over the open waters of the Gulf of Mexico. So it's still very uncertain about the exact track and exactly what's going to be happening with Chantal. So it's very important that you keep it tuned to the Weather Channel, and we'll bring you the very latest regarding this tropical system. Now, elsewhere, as we have another satellite perspective of Chantal, we can see continuing to spin across the Caribbean at this point. Most of the Gulf of Mexico, though, rather quiet in comparison. And a little bit farther off to the east, we see the remains of a little weak tropical depression, too, or not tropical depression, but tropical disturbance that's been approaching the Lesser Antilles. And that will likely bring a few spotty showers and storms, especially to some of the southern islands, over about the next 12 hours or so. Elsewhere, though, downstream from there, we have another tropical wave, though, about halfway between Africa and South America. And this one does show a little sign now of perhaps some circulation with this one, so we'll certainly have to watch this. If there is any development, the development will be very slow to take place over the next couple of days or so. Next, we head over towards the eastern Pacific. And here, too, we're seeing some disturbed weather, clusters of showers and storms, though, but nothing is showing any signs of organization. And lastly, we head to the western Pacific, where we have Typhoon Pabuk. And boy, this is a big typhoon right now. It is packing winds of close to 110 miles per hour. This one will likely track closer towards Kyoto, Japan. Definitely some rough conditions likely for Japan over the next few days or so, and we'll continue to keep you updated. In the meantime, though, let's kind of switch gears. We'll see what's happening stateside. And for your Monday, a good part of the country could be rather stormy and unsettled. We're tracking a low-pressure area that continues to pinwheel its way across the eastern lakes, basically centered somewhere close across southern parts of Ontario. It is dragging a frontal boundary along with it, and as the front continues to slip to the east, it has been triggering some showers and storms this morning, and so far the brunt of the rain continues over southern parts of New England, especially around Falmouth and New Bedford and Back over across the islands around Martha's Vineyard in Nantucket this morning, you're getting walloped with heavy rain. And that is kind of a precursor of things to come because there will continue to be some scattered showers and thunderstorms for the northeastern corridor, at least through later this afternoon. So again, we could be seeing some rough conditions for the East Coast. Perhaps a few strong thunderstorms could be popping up across the southeast. And much like we've seen for the past several weeks, with that monsoonal moisture too flowing up the Four Corners area, that moisture combined with afternoon heating will also set the stage for some scattered showers and storms. So here's the forecast for your Monday. We're watching the front again easing its way towards the eastern seaboard. The rain lined up along the coast. More rains too increasing across the southeastern states. And we do expect most of the action today around Birmingham and basically south of Macon, Georgia. The west will initially start off rather quiet, but come later this afternoon, as the atmosphere becomes increasingly unstable, here too we'll have a smattering of showers and storms. They could bring some really rough conditions to Boulder and Denver, and perhaps to around Phoenix a little bit later on today. Rainfall amounts typically averaging a quarter to about a half.
Forecast for your area. Extended forecast.
Tropical storm Chantal remains poorly disorganized. For the very latest on Chantal, here's hurricane expert Dr. John Ho.
Well, thank you, Melissa, and it does remain very organized, and we expect it to maybe begin to get a little bit better organized as time goes by. Let's go ahead and have a look at it here. It is now not very far away from the coast of the Yucatan Peninsula and Belize, and as a result of that, the tropical storm warnings are up all the way from Cancun down to Belize-Guatemala border. It's moving toward the west-northwest at about 15 miles an hour, and we believe it's going to be making landfall there sometime this evening. Top winds are 65 miles an hour. We can see a little bit of evidence of it getting slightly better organized, but time is pretty much running out for this to be a hurricane. Although it's not all that much short of hurricane force right now, the top winds are 65 miles an hour. And a hurricane watch is out from Cancun down to Belize City. That is for the possibility that this will become a hurricane before landfall. But as time goes by, we think that's a little bit less likely. And here's our forecast swath, and it's marching right along to the west-northwest. And we do expect it to be making landfall along the Yucatan Peninsula, north, I think, of Chetumal, and perhaps a little bit south of Cancun and Cozumel. And we'll do that pretty early this evening. Now, the good thing about that is, as far as any development is concerned, once the center gets inland over the Yucatan Peninsula, we're sure it won't intensify there. We'll still have to be concerned about it when it gets out here in the Bay of Campeche, but we have lots of time to wait for that. In the meantime, here's our latest satellite picture, and right about here is where that circulation center is. And again, we can see it getting just a little bit better organized, but we're not too concerned about this because we think it'll make landfall certainly within the next 7, 8, 9, 10 hours, something like that. And again, it's very asymmetrical. The strong winds are on the north side, so there won't be much of any wind on the south side of it at all. But the north, up around Cancun or so, there should be some pretty good winds developing as this goes on. Now, this is what the infrared picture looks like. And right about in here, again, is the circulation. It never has for the last couple days, but underneath the deep thunderstorms. And that tells us that the system is not terribly well organized. Temperatures, sea surface temperatures are plenty warm enough, as you can see, up in the upper 80s. And there's the overall picture of the Caribbean showing Chantal down right here in the Caribbean Sea. And farther out, we have another system we wanted to mention to you. It's right out in here. It's about 800 miles away from the islands. And we do have to watch that for possible development. It doesn't have a lot of concentration of thunderstorms, but it's only 800 miles away from the islands and moving westward pretty rapidly, so we'll be watching that as well. That's the tropics for this time. Now back to Melissa.
And across the lower 48, a severe thunderstorm warning right now in Arkansas County, across southeastern Arkansas right now. And we have been dealing with severe weather across the state throughout the morning. Across the rest of the lower 48, some scattered showers here across the southeast, and also across parts of the northeast, and some wet weather here across the Four Corners region, where we are expecting to see some scattered showers and some embedded thunderstorms come later on this afternoon. Stay with us. Weather Center's up next.
This program was sponsored by Honda Power.
Daddy!
What is it?
The light's out.
Don't worry, honey. Daddy will fix it.
An easy-to-start Honda generator can power dozens of necessities, like a heater, refrigerator, television, or something really important. Like a 4-watt anti-monster defense system.
Honda generators are available at a dealer near you.
Big brother, little brother. Car keys, cartoons. Plays in a band, plays in the sand. 6'3", 3'6". What brings these two to the table? Honey Nut Chex. The taste of golden honey and nuts that's sweet, but not too sweet. So everybody likes it. What'll they agree on next? Maybe girls? Maybe in a couple of years. Honey Nut Chex, bringing families together. For breakfast, anyway.
Welcome to the neighborhood.
Hey, neighbor. I whipped up a delicious crab cob salad and these mouth-watering crab portobello mushrooms. Oh. Nice mold.
Enjoy mouth-watering crab at Red Lobster's Festival of Crab. Entree start at just $9.99. Red Lobster, go overboard.
You love seafood, we love seafood.
The forecast for your area. Wednesday, we'll have temperatures in the low 80s. Under sunny skies, expect a chance of thunderstorms on Thursday and Friday.
We've had some pretty big thunderstorms over the Northeast and in the Carolinas, as well as into Florida. We'll detail all of that coming up. But first, let's get the very latest on the tropics, including tropical storm Chantal. Here's our severe weather, or excuse me, our tropical expert, Dr. Steve Lyons.
Thanks, Greg. And we do have a near landfalling tropical storm in the Yucatan Peninsula. Let's look at the large scale picture of the tropics, and I'll show you our trouble areas. We have one very weak low pressure area in the central Atlantic. You can't even see it because there are hardly any thunderstorms with it, so there's not much concern with that. Our big concern is that big red blob in the left-hand portion of your screen, and that is our tropical storm, Chantal. Now, the impacts we're going to talk about first from Chantal, none of them are going to be high, but we expect winds to be in the 40 to 50 mile per hour range north of the circulation center. Rainfall will be in about the 4 to 7 inch range at and north of the center. Wave action to be in the 20 to 25 foot range north of the center, and surge to be about 2 to 3 feet north of the center. And on top of that, surge will have some wave, what we call setup, about 2 to 3 feet north of the center. So where is the circulation right now? Well, right now it's sitting right there, and you can see our impact is going to be along that dotted line. So if you're down here in Belize, you're going to have some offshore winds and really not too much action, and even all the heavy rain is still well offshore. It's going to make landfall here in a couple more hours, But all of the impact to the north along the Yucatan Peninsula is going to lag behind just a little bit, except the wave action, which is already up to about 15 to 18 feet, is going to continue to grow overnight. I expect it to continue to move to the west-northwest. And when we look at the latest information from the Hurricane Center, you can see west-northwest at 14. Wind 65 miles per hour. We currently do not expect it to be a hurricane. It's running out of room to become one. And as it moves across the Yucatan Peninsula, we expect it to weaken. How much it'll weaken? Probably anywhere from 15 to 25 miles per hour, and it will come back out into the Bay of Campeche over the next 24 hours or so. And when it does so, it will probably, or it has the potential to become a hurricane. Now we do have tropical storm warnings up on each side of the peninsula. Keep in mind down here in Belize, we're not likely to see much in the way of tropical storm winds unless they're in squalls and heavy showers after the circulation passes by. Here's our projected path, and we still think it's going to keep on that southern track and head on to the west into northern Mexico. However, if you're in the southern portion of Texas, keep an eye on this one. Let's get back to Jeff in the studio.
All right, thank you very much, Dr. Steve Lyons. Here we go into New England, where we've had some severe weather, even a tornado warning earlier today in Fairfield County, southwest Connecticut. No confirmed touchdowns, but the Doppler radar had indicated some rotation. That cluster of storms now moving into Rhode Island, Narragansett Bay under a special marine advisory. Looks like right up around the Providence area, you're about ready to get hit with some fairly heavy rain, some lightning, and maybe some brief gusty winds. And any small craft out on Narragansett Bay should be heading to shelter very quickly. We also have some heavier showers and storms in parts of eastern North Carolina. The Outer Banks have dried out a bit, but bigger storms along I-95 from the Virginia border to South Carolina.
People do some strange things to cars. That's why there's Carfax. We'll give you the real history of any used car, and that could save you thousands. Go to Carfax.com or ask your dealer for a Carfax report. Don't buy a used car without Carfax.
Ask your dealer for a Carfax report or visit Carfax.com.
Hi, Billy Mays here for OxyClean, the stain specialist. Powered by the air you breathe, activated by the water that you and I drink. It's Mother Nature approved, then it's safe on your colored fabrics. Use it on carpets. OxyClean seeks out organic stains, pet stains, food stains. They get down into the matting, into the padding. It even takes red wine and grape juice out of white carpeting. It cleans, it brightens, it eliminates odors all at the same time. Don't just get it clean, get it OxyClean. Make a paste, make it 10 times as powerful. The longer you let it set, the easier it is. It'll whiten your grout and get rid of your toughest stains. Sometimes soaking is the solution. If you use bleach, you ruin your clothes.
Order Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon on In Demand. The in-demand movies you want start every half hour on Comcast Digital Cable.
For your local forecast on the Weather Channel. Currently, the temperature is 72 degrees under fair skies. The forecast for your area. Wednesday, we'll have temperatures in the low 80s under sunny skies. Expect a chance of thunderstorms on Thursday and Friday.
Allison, Barry, now Chantal. The first two made landfall in the United States. Chantal makes landfall in Mexico. Good evening, I'm Dave Schwartz with Stormwatch. These are the latest data from the National Hurricane Center in Miami, showing the tropical storm's center near the city of Chetumal, Mexico, in Yucatan, right near the Yucatan-Belize border. Maximum sustained winds at landfall, 70 miles per hour. So this is a very similar, in strength, tropical storm to Barry, which hit the Florida panhandle last month. West-northwest at 13 miles per hour and forecast to slow down just a little bit. That means very heavy rain and flooding for Yucatan. 8 to 12 inches of rain possible with this tropical system, which strengthened just before it hit landfall to its lowest pressure that it ever has been, 1,001 millibars, 28.56 inches of mercury. But now that it is on land, it will weaken and be a rainmaker. There it is, the center now making landfall just north of the Belize-Yucatan border. Get your perspective here. That's Cuba. This is South Florida. And this continues to move west-northwest in the northwestern Caribbean. Gulf of Mexico is all clear. A trough of low pressure has dropped into the Gulf of Mexico right now. This will move across the Yucatan Peninsula tonight and then reemerge in the so-called Bay of Campeche. That's what this bay is called, this portion of the Gulf of Mexico, the Bay of Campeche, which may have been dug out by an asteroid millions of years ago. This tropical storm will do its dirty work here in the Yucatan Peninsula tonight and tomorrow and then reemerge. And then at this point, we think that it will continue to move to the west. It may strengthen here once it weakens tonight, and then on Thursday night or Friday, make landfall again in Mexico. So that's where Tropical Storm Chantal is. Tropical storm warnings are in effect on both coasts. Now, we've got onshore winds here, strong north of the center, lighter offshore winds here in Belize, so there won't be water piling up along the coast. But sea is running 2 to 4 feet above average right on shore. The sea level will actually rise even for the next 4 to 8 hours, even in the wake of this thing, as the water and the wind just keep piling up. So there'll be some coastal flooding here for sure. And then on the west coast, we've got some onshore winds also that could reach tropical storm status. Elsewhere in the tropical Atlantic, this tropical wave has our eye. It actually has an area of low pressure with it, though not much in the way of shower activity. Once again, the Gulf of Mexico is all clear. West coast of Mexico also all clear. And all is fine here in Hawaii with our northeast trades. We've got partly cloudy skies this afternoon and temperatures in the 80s. Got some stormy weather here in the U.S. We'll detail that coming up next on Weather Center.
This program was sponsored by Honda Power.
Daddy!
What is it?
The lights out.
Don't worry, honey. Daddy will fix it.
An easy-to-start Honda generator can power dozens of necessities, like a heater, refrigerator, television, or something really important. Like a 4-watt anti-monster defense system.
Honda generators are available at a dealer near you.